This place to witness the joining of Lynsey and Paul in holy marriage. Marriage was instituted for the happiness it brings and cherished and guarded through the ages. The joining of two lives into one common life does not begin and will not end with this service of marriage. It is rather a continuing process to which Paul and Lynsey have committed themselves today. As each seeks happiness of the other, both seek happiness of those about them. Unsought happiness will come to them. Who brings Lynsey to be married to Paul? Love is a great thing. By itself, it makes everything that is heavy light. It bears evenly all that is uneven. It carries a burden which is no burden. It will not be kept back by anything low or mean. It is not to be entangled by any outward prosperity or by any adversity subdued. Love feels no burden, thinks nothing of trouble, attempts what is above its strength, and pleads no excuse of impossibility. It is therefore able to undertake all things. It completes many things and warns them to take effect. For he who does not love would faint and lie down. Though weary, though not tired, though alarmed, is not confound. But it is a living flame that forces its way upward and securely passes through all. Love is active, love is sincere, courageous, patient, faithful, and prudent. If you then, Paul and Lynsey, have freely chosen each other, a token of this and your love, will you please join hands?
Yes.
Paul, do you take Lynsey to be your wedded wife, to have and to hold from this day forward, in sickness and in health, in plenty and in want, to laugh with her in joy, to grieve with her in sorrow, grow with her in love, serving the world in peace and hope, as long as you both shall live. Lynsey, do you take Paul to be your wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, in sickness and in health, in plenty and in want, to laugh with him in joy, to grieve with him in sorrow, to grow with him in love, serving the world in peace and hope, as long as you both shall live. The vows which have been exchanged by Paul and Lynsey have been offered in our hearing, but words are fleeting and their sound fades and is soon gone. The wedding ring is a symbol of the promises made here today. May the wedding band be a reminder to all the vows Lynsey and Paul have made and a witness to the world of their commitment and marriage. Place this ring on the hand of your bride and repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed. And with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you. Right. Lynsey, place this ring on the hand of your groom and repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed, and with all that I am and all that I have, I honor you. Now with your hands joined, and with your hands your hearts, these are the hands of your best friend, young, strong, and full of love for you, that are holding your hands on your wedding day, as you promise to love each other today, tomorrow, and forever. These are the hands that will work alongside yours as you together build a future. These are the hands that will passionately love you and cherish you through the years, and with the slightest touch will comfort you like no other. These are the hands that will hold you when fear or grief fills your mind. And these are the hands that will countless times unspoken tenderness with just a touch. Now that Paul and Lynsey have given themselves to each other by solemn vows, the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings, I announce to you that they are husband and wife. Paul, you may kiss the bride. Present to you Mr. and Mrs. Paul David Petrovic.